Hi, I'm Greg Wilson, Commercialization Product Manager here at Equinix. In this video, I'm going to talk about the prerequisites and network planning for Equinix Precision Time. First, let's discuss the prerequisites required to provision our service. Equinix Precision Time is delivered over Equinix Fabric. This means you need a physical Equinix Fabric port that is connected to your network infrastructure within one of our data centers. Alternatively, if you don't have a physical presence, you can use a virtual network device provided through our network edge service to connect our timing servers to your network. If you are the user signing up for a new Equinix Precision Time service, you need to have a customer account on the Equinix customer portal. This account must also have permissions to view your fabric ports and create new L2 and virtual connections. Further information can be found in the Equinix prerequisites page on the Equinix documentation site. Please contact your master administrator or your Equinix customer success manager to get the right permissions. Now let's talk about network planning. For both PTP and NTP, you can configure your devices for direct or cascaded consumption. In the direct consumption model, your devices synchronize for time directly with the Equinix Precision Time master servers. The other option is to use the cascade consumption model. In this model, you will use your own time master or masters, which source precision time from our service and then serve NTP or PTP to your end clients. A hybrid model of direct and cascade can be used if desired. In either consumption model, you need to set up a VLAN for your devices and the fabric port. This VLAN ID is needed when configuring the new service. Equinix Precision Time will create a new virtual connection between your ports and our time masters to connect the layer 2 networks. This will put the time master servers in your private subnet. You need to plan on allocating private IP addresses for the two time master servers and a default gateway if one is necessary. By default, this will be done over a single fabric port. If you would like to use redundant fabric ports, you will need to make sure you have a primary and secondary port. The configuration of the VLAN and network settings are the same as the single port setup. One more thing you will need to determine is the tier of service. We have a standard and enterprise tier for both NTP and PTP. The biggest difference between tiers is the number of devices that can connect to the service via the direct consumption model. These limits will be displayed in the portal when you sign up. The other thing to note is that our NTP standard tier service does not support the use of a default gateway or redundant ports. Thank you for watching this video. In the next video, we will show you how to subscribe to a new service. For more details about prerequisites and network planning, please visit our documentation site, docs.equinix.com, and look for Equinix Precision Time, Getting Started.